You can already become very powerful in the early game of Ghost of Tsushima thanks to different upgrades that you can unlock really fast if you know where to go and what tactics you need to do. So in this video, I want to show you how to get a head start in the early game so you can even one-shot some particular enemies. A like on the video would be super appreciated. And let's go. When you enter the open world for the first time, you immediately want to go to the question mark location. Maybe you've already cleared this camp, but then you've already killed the leader as well after destroying the black powder. And after this fight, you will see that you need two more leaders to unlock the water stance. And this stance will be very handy against enemies with shields, breaking their defense with just one strike. So you want to unlock this stance as soon as possible. But before we do that, we first want to talk to the vendor here who showed up now that the Ogawa Dojo is cleared. From this character, you namely get the Traveler's Attire, an outfit that clears extra fog of war when exploring the map. So totally wear this outfit when you are exploring the world, so you reveal way more of the map. And we will get back to this outfit in a second, because you want to upgrade it as soon as possible. But first, we want to go to this question mark that is close by. That's also in camp, because here we will be able to observe and kill a leader to then immediately unlock the water stance. So set the marker, and when you then reach this location, you want to climb over the fence and hold R2 to observe the leader. Totally do this for every leader you encounter later on, by the way, because they will give you then two unlocks towards your next stance instead of just one that you get for killing them. You can already see when entering a camp if you are able to observe and kill the leader. So if the leader is already after you but you weren't able to observe him yet, then totally go away and then come back so you're still able to get that observe point as well. So let's go back to that previous example. We just observed the leader and now we can do a standoff. And these leaders can be pretty hard, but with a standoff, you can kill them in one hit if you perfectly time the triangle move. And then you immediately have the water stance after like 20 minutes in the open world. Again, that makes fighting shield wearing enemies way easier. One triangle and you can easily finish them off. The next step is pretty obvious, but still noteworthy, because you want to do those two first main story missions before exploring the rest of the world. Because simple things like being able to assassinate the target and shooting a bow are not unlocked from the start, but after doing these two missions, you get them. So totally do them first before you explore the rest of the map. And again, when exploring the world, you totally want to use that Traveler's Attire, but you also want to get it to rank 3 as soon as possible, because this will clear 30% more fog. So the sooner you have this, the faster you clear the whole world. You need linen and leather for this, and linen is pretty easily obtainable from small tills, so side missions in the game. And you can already find two of them that both give 10 linen over here on the map. And totally while doing these missions and just other activities in general, be on the lookout for iron, supplies and other resources that will all come in handy when you want to upgrade your gear. From these two missions, you also get one charm each. One boosts healing by 7.5% and the other makes it harder for enemies to detect you. And during the Other Side of Honor mission, you also come across a hot spring that gives you a health boost, so totally go back to unlock that. And close by this hot spring, you find a shrine that you also want to visit for an even better charm. Climbing to the top will namely get you the melee charm that increases your damage while below 50% health. So this is nice early on in the game, but actually also later on in the game. And there are way more nice locations nearby, like Fox Dance that will help you unlock more charm slots, so they are totally worth visiting. But there's also another hot spring close to the Golden Temple. And you see some other locations in this early area that I already unlocked. And I will likely do videos on all the hot springs and stuff like that later on. And the Golden Temple is very important. And if you've done the Tale of Lady Masako main mission, the third main mission actually in the open world, then you will reach this location. So I would complete that main mission first and then return to the Golden Temple, because we got some important things here. First of all, speak to the person at the gift altar that will already unlock a pretty cool mask, but also give you many resources after completing side missions. And by hovering over the Golden Temple icon on the map, you see if new gifts are available. So You totally want to revisit this location whenever there are new things for you to grab. Now to make our character way better, we want to go to the swordsmith. You should be able to do the first upgrade already if you collected a lot of iron that is laying around everywhere. Steel is a little harder to get, although there is a tactic to get an unlimited amount of steel. And for this we want to go to the Traveler's Rest Inn location that is close to the first camp you captured. Clear out the Mongols here first if you haven't already. And then you find a chest in the main building that contains one steel and some supplies. And then by simply fast traveling to this location, something you can do after you've cleared the Mongols, you will see that the chest has respawned. So then run towards the house again and grab the chest to get more steel and then rinse and repeat. And you will see that the NPCs will also have things to say here. Sometimes they get new things to say when you like fast travel to this location again. So totally talk to them to unlock some extra locations on the map. But overall for this tactic, all you need to do, fast travel to this location, get the chest, grab the steel, fast travel again, and get the chest until you got like a lot of steel so you can upgrade your blade. You need 15 steel for the first 3 upgrades. So with this tactic, you can actually get that super fast. But then you might be low on iron or supplies. There's an old trading post nearby with iron as a reward for clearing it. But also in this trading post, there is a lot of iron laying around. So totally clear this out. And then you should have enough to get the katana to rank 4 already. But we also want to check the armor fender to upgrade our traveler's attire. You should, when you reach the Golden Temple for the first time, already have enough for the first upgrade. But you want to get the third one as well. And you need 10 leather for that and also 20 linen. And I already got the linen at this point, also thanks to the gift altar. And I got some leather from that too. You will also actually find leather in the house at the start of the Mexico Tale. At least that's where I found it. So then you just need to do one side mission and you actually find this one over here. It's very close to get all the leather you need. But then you might find that after upgrading your katana to rank 4, that you will still need some supplies to get the third upgrade for this armor. And really the best place for supplies is the shipyard that they showed in the state of play. You find it over here on the map, so that's pretty close to the shrine that gave you the extra damage while below 50% health bonus. So the shipyard is a relatively challenging area for early in the game, but because we already upgraded our blade to rank 4, we should easily be able to clear it. Like, the archers now die from one hit, so you should be good. Important to know though, is that you do not want to destroy the location. You can complete any other objective, totally kill all the enemies, but do not blow it up, because then I don't think this tactic works anymore. You might already encounter multiple chests when clearing this camp, but let's do the run from the start. And for that, we have to die. And you can easily do that by getting on top of the ship here and then simply jumping down. Now we respawn and we immediately want to go to the right and climb up and then enter this second hut, because inside you will find a chest. Now go down and get inside here, because then you will find another chest, and every chest in this area has supplies. So now we want to drop down, because in front of the ship you will find another chest, and then we want to go via the left side and then enter the ship, and then on your left hand you want to go inside the ship, grab the chest there, and then we want to go outside again, get higher up, and then you will find a chest on your left hand side. And now you can jump up again and then drop down again to die and respawn. And then you can really do this over and over again. And you get like more than 100 supplies per run, like 120 or something. So that will totally be enough for any upgrades in the future if you just keep doing this run and do not destroy the shipyard. So yes, then you can upgrade the traveler's attire, and you can likely upgrade your bow a few times as well if you got a ton of supplies from this tactic and picked up some bamboo along the way. And now I think it's smart to focus on the samurai clan armor and also upgrade that, because this will be the best combat armor for a while. But I will have more unlimited farm tactics to help you upgrade things as soon as possible, up really really soon, or maybe already up by the time you watch this. And we of course also unlocked some skill points right now too. We'll have videos on the skills and which one you want to upgrade to. So totally subscribe for everything on Ghost of Tsushima. A like on the video would be super appreciated. And totally, of course, if you got some early game tips after playing yourself, then totally drop them down in the comments down below. I would love to hear them, and maybe I will use them for a future video and shout you out then too. You can watch another Ghost of Tsushima video by clicking on the screen. And for now, I will speak to you next time. Have fun in the game and goodbye.